नोटिस भी देके रखते हैं और सो कमेंट कर दे हमको हमको दा 25 रुपए दो हमको ये दो दे दे वर्क लाइक दैट एंड इट वर्क्स सो इन स्लम्स आल्सो इट्स गॉट अ गुड रेवेन्यू मॉडल गुड अप्रिसिएशन एंड इट आल्सो हैज अ गुड अप्रिसिएशन इन फॉर इवेंट्स कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट्स ऑफ कोर्स इट्स दैट्स द मेन 80% ऑफ द बिजनेस इज कम्स फ्रॉम इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट्स See, the thing is that whenever you offer a franchising, the most important thing that you have to control is the quality of the services or goods or whatever, and also the technology and the control of the finance, right? Because you can't go wrong on that. And both these things you can do with good amount of dealer management or franchisee management. You have to have a good staff that does the price checks, that does lots of quality audits and things like that. And we've not had really big problems. I think franchises do a really good job, and probably in some cases even better than some of our own outfits in other parts. For the prime reason that the number of units that they maintain are smaller, and that their service is so when they reach a certain critical mass, that's when they really start tumbling down. So what we do is when they are approaching that critical mass, we really don't let them go beyond that because they can't manage it on their own. So typically it's a mama and papa store where the mama is making the invoices and papa is doing the cleaning and everything. So it runs very well because typically the mama and papa is making maybe 15,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees in a job, you know, together. But when they start this particular service, they probably make 100,000 rupees a month. It sort of puts them in a different league altogether. So we are targeting that kind of level of people, especially for the slums and for lower groups. And for events and for cities, even people like, for example, there is a metal in Nagpur. There's a metal steel trading company who used to own by a very big company who has taken up a franchise for Nagpur. For you know, they're interested in doing. I think they're doing a good job. So.
Don't you think that the franchises can replicate the model and start their own brand?
See, they can. I mean, see, look, our brand is strong, and nobody cannot. Do their own thing. They can. They're free to do it. But see, the investment that you have as a franchisee put into us, and we have put into you, the first investment is faith. Trust. No business can work without faith or trust. Just as you have come forward to me that I want to start a business and I want to, you know, become successful. Similarly, I have also put in that faith in you that I want to increase my brand awareness, and you are the person to take this forward. So it's a win-win situation, a symbiotic situation for both of us. So it starts with trust. Yes, sometimes people don't want to move ahead because of some stringent plans or because they are not comfortable. That could happen either ways. You know, it could be from the franchisee side, it could be from our side also. So one hour problem could happen. But yes, to maintain the efficiency and the efficacy of the whole thing, the branding, you know, the control is very important. And if you can do that to a large extent, you resolve the problem. You are marketing 3S, you are marketing your brand everywhere. So if tomorrow 3S stops, ceases, all your accounts, all your customers, everything is still with you. Your control is with you. If the person even wants to move out, the customers don't know you. They know 3S. So you may get some amount of business, you know, as a spun off, you know, business that you have some clients that you've met with. But as a company, we meet your clients from time to time. We build faith in your clients also. So we have small conventions, small seminars, we talk about hygiene, we call them over a cup of tea. Now these things a small entrepreneur or a small enterprise cannot do. You know, when you grow larger, then you can have these conventions, you can have these meetings in five-star hotels and all that. This is part and parcel of getting people together to know your customer. Why does a big company like Mahindra & Mahindra, for example, why would they have a dealer conference at a five-star resort in Thailand where they call all their customers over there? It's because not just the dealers, even the customers come there where you can get to know the customer directly. So if your biggest customer is buying 100 trucks from you or whatever, you get to meet him directly. So the dealer, yes, is important and you have that faith in him. But sometimes the dealer would, you know, sort of introduce the two of you. And then you interact with that person. So this is on a similar line that we also work. You know, we like to interact with our clients, we speak to our clients, we give offers. I mean, if a client, we get a report on our ERP that this particular client is really doing well, we give him a loyalty bonus, we give him free tickets for a movie, you know, things like that directly to the client from the company. That doesn't go through the dealer. So he gets a post letter in his box that, you know, you've got two tickets to a movie at Inox or E-Square or whatever it is. So we've been doing such initiatives.
So there is no official agreement, like you cannot start something.
There's a very strong legal binding agreement that until 2 years after you will say you cannot do it. But see, you can't control those things, right? If somebody wants to do it, you can still do it. I mean, even if I sue you, Indian legal system is such that